special meeting, North Smithfield Town Council, May 1st, 2017. Time is 7:06. Open meeting, Madam Clerk, we lead us in a prayer of life.
The Holy Spirit of council, all those who are serving in positions of authority and responsibility.
To the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, liberty, and justice for all.
Roll call, please.
Mr. Halloran.
Yes.
McGee.
Yes.
Ms. O'Hara.
Yes.
Present.
Here. North Smithfield Town Council sitting as the Board of License Commissioners. Holiday sales license, TNT fireworks. Chris Lutheran.
Lutheran, yeah. Need my address?
Please.
Yeah, just for the record.
Sure. 17 Hesse Road, H-E-S-S-E, Hampton, Connecticut, H-A-N-D-E-N.
Thank you.
Oh, we're just applying for the holiday sales, as we've done every year. We're going to be having a 20-by-40 tent, selling all legal fireworks for the state of Rhode Island.
Motion to approve. For a second?
Second. Discussion, discussion. What date, yes, what dates for when to win?
Getting ahead of ourselves, I guess.
Generally speaking, the tents are usually open about 10 days from roughly about the 25th of June to the 4th, give or take a day or two.
So you promoted June 15th to July what?
I'm sorry?
You said 10 days before.
Usually, like, the tents are open about the 23rd, 24th, 25th to July 4th is when they're selling.
So June 21st to July 4th? How about the 5th, in case you want to do something?
No, the 5th, we're all done on the 4th, and then the 5th, we pack it up and head out of town.
No sales, and get ready to get ready.
We're going to go in the night, and we're recovering our...
What are your hours?
The hours are usually 9 to 9 or 10 to 10.
So, one more time for clarification, but when do you want to start selling? What's the first day?
I mean, we would like to sell probably, if we could, ideally the 21st, 22nd.
Okay, and you're going to be done July, you sure July 4th, you want to go July 5th?
No, we will definitely not be selling July 5th.
Okay.
Yes, I'll make the motion I'll make the motion that the sales license be granted from July 23rd to... From June 23rd to July 4th, the hours of 10 a.m. to 10 p.m. From June 21st to July 4th, the hours 10 a.m. to 10 p.m.
Second.
Any further discussion? Roll call, please.
Mr. Halloran.
Yes.
Mr. McGee.
Yes.
Ms. O'Hara.
Yes.
Mrs. Lysinski.
Yes.
Erica?
Yes. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much.
The luck, so what's the problem?
Yeah.
Request for outdoor sound system permit, Knights of Columbus, Ms. Bagnan.
Mr. President, I'm the council, Freedom Council of Knights of Columbus, seeking an outdoor sound permit for a car show that we hold right here at the middle school. This year is going to be on July 30th. It takes place from about 10 to 2. And with that car show, we give more than $1,000 scholarship to the student at high school. We have all the approvals that we need from the school department, so we're now looking for outdoor sound permit.
Motion to approve.
Motion.
Make the motion.
Second.
Discussion. Hey, Paul, every year, which is not a big deal, we do this every year. Do we have any type of police presence last year?
We do. We contact the chief, and we actually have them put up no parking signs on Ridgeville Road and Providence Pike, both sides of the road, so there's no parking on each side. They have to park in the parking lot, show cars cars are all down here. And the police actually do come in and walk around. Last year, we tried to set up a program with them with a posse safety check. We just had inclement weather, so we did.
So traffic control and parking control as well, periodic police presence. Right, thank you.
Do we have a motion? Do we have a second? Any further discussion? Roll call, please.
Mrs. Halloran?
Yes.
Mr. McGee?
Yes.
Mrs. O'Hara?
Yes.
Mrs. Malinsky?
Yes.
Mr. Biragad?
Yes.
While you're up there. What's that?
So thank you.
You're welcome. And while you're up there, discussion by council, vote on other action and update by the Charter Review Commission.
Mr. President, I'm here to ask for an extension of time to continue with the charter review. By resolution, we were supposed to have a report done on the 1st of May today. But actually, the resolution was created in April, and the committee didn't get populated until August of last year. And when we came to the council last year, the previous council, they said if we needed more time to come back to the council, see if we can get more time. Two reasons. One, I would say we have most of the heavy lifting done, that we need to get done. We have a couple of issues that we need to sort through and get clarification on. Just so you guys are aware, we've been meeting almost every week since August of last year. We met three times with the solicitor to get his input on how to frame these things legally so that they're correctly worded. But we still have a few issues outstanding. And we didn't want to rush it and then dump it with you guys, knowing that you're going to start the budget process right now as well. So we felt that the best thing to do would be to take a little more time, make sure that we got it all set. When you guys meet up, then maybe we come back the end of July, maybe in August.
Would you think maybe September, after September? Would you think after September?
Well, I would think it would be here before September. So I say the end of July, beginning of August. And the only other thing I would suggest is that when we do present this, it be a special meeting. The only item on the agenda, it could be a meeting.
Okay. Mr. President, Paul, I think the end of August, you know, people are getting ready to go to school. It can come up right after Labor Day. We can do it.
Well, we have to present our findings to you or our recommendations to you, and as we go forward looking at it, we see numerous public presentations going on.
Oh yeah.
And it would be us up there explaining why we're going to make those changes, but we need to run it through you first. Maybe at that meeting, then we also have the school department there, all of our elected officials there, because it will impact a lot of them. But it would be, I would suggest a special meeting. That's the only thing on the agenda. And we probably do it with a PowerPoint presentation you could actually see it up there, what changes we're looking to make, not just off of a piece of paper. Everybody could see it.
All right. Mr. President, I'd like to make a motion to continue this to a date certain so we can have an update by the Charter Review Commission. Date certain, Paul? You think August, September?
August.
Okay, and then we can move it forward. We'll continue in August. If you're not ready, then we'll move it up again as usual.
Okay.
That's
appreciate
it.
For a second.
Second.
Further discussion? Roll call.
Mr. Halloran?
Yes.
Mr. McGee?
Yes.
Mrs. O'Hara?
Yes.
Mr. Malinsky?
Yes.
Mr. Biragad?
Yes.
Thank you. Moving on, item number six. We had on the agenda a public hearing regarding the tentative contract with the North Smithfield Association of Support Staff Personnel, but due to a procedural issue, Section 9 of the Town Charter, this has to go before the Budget Committee before we can act on it. However, if there's anybody here in the audience that wanted to speak on this,
just to make sure that no one wants to speak.
Right, that's what I was just going to ask. I think as anybody here.
If I may, it's just proceduralized. It's okay to move ahead with this without the report.
We're not going to go ahead with the budget report.
I'm sorry, we don't have the report of the budget.
It's going to be your opinion. It's
So we're just going to, we're going to open this up so folks can just speak if they wish, and we're going to continue.
To a date, sir.
Thanks.
So is there anybody in the audience that wanted to speak on this? All right, so we're going to continue it with...
So I would just, as a matter of procedure, I would move to open up the public hearing, because today we scheduled, otherwise the clerk's going to have to be advertised. Move to open up the public hearing. That's the first thing I would recommend. Ask if anybody wants to speak. If they don't, indicate that you're continuing to a date, sir. And then pick that date, sir.
Mr. President, as listed on the town council meeting of May 1st, 2017, under item number 6, public hearing, tentative contract for North Smithfield Association of Support Staff. Due to procedural issues, I'm going to make a motion that we open up the public hearing. That's a motion.
Second. We have a second?
Second.
Roll call.
Mr. Halloran?
Yes.
Mr. McGee?
Yes.
Mrs. O'Hara?
Yes.
Mr. Zalinski?
Yes.
Mr. Birka?
Yes. Now, once again, I'll ask if there's anybody in the audience that wants to speak on this, that came in for this specific reason. Good. So nobody? Going? Okay.
Mr. President, I'd like to make a motion to continue item 6. I'm sorry, yes, item 6. Public hearing, tentative contract for North Smithfield Associates Support Staff Personnel until such time that we receive an opinion or a report of the North Smithfield Budget Committee. We have to get that report from them.
So I agree, but we still have to pick a date.
I don't know when that report's going to come.
I understand that, but we pick a date.
Yeah.
What's not then, you know, on that date, we can continue the public hearing.
Second meeting in May, then? What is that?
15.
May 15th will be the next, continue to May 15th. That's a motion.
Second.
Second.
Roll call.
Mr. Halloran?
Yes.
Mr. McGee?
Yes.
Mrs. O'Hara?
Yes.
Mr. Zalinski?
Yes.
Mr. Birka?
Yes. Okay, somebody, I guess, you're all set.
Thank you. Obviously, if anybody has any questions, feel free to call me. The finance director has an issue with the meeting, maybe. I'm pressing you, but we'd like to get this done as we go on since May 2015.
Okay.
Thank you.
I'm moving on to old business. Discussion by council, vote on other action on appointments, boards and commissions, the assessors, board of review. This one keeps coming up. Does anybody have any recommendations for this position? Scott, you want to just continue this one? New business. Discussion by council, vote on other action on approval of contract for access to property located at 582 Great Road. This is the Brickell property. Mr. Zofsky and Mr. Kravitz, are going to speak on this?
This is effectively Grand River Village, which you guys are familiar with that. Project. Town put a lot of resources into that. I have plans here. I reviewed the comprehensive plan. Gary and I have been speaking about it and how to effectuate that, get it off the ground. And I think Gary had a good idea here with respect to, we talked about the chicken egg scenario with respect to land use. We feel that for this particular project is a light industrial or commercial component to it with office space, essentially south of the railroad crossing that goes through the property, if you're familiar with that. There's an opportunity to provide for what we hope to have direct access to 146, which would make the property much more attractive and marketable from the commercial office perspective especially. Do do that, we could modify the northerly ramp from Palmer Road onto 146. Effectively, it would not adjust where the ramp enters 146, which makes this, I'm not going to say easy, but certainly easier than adding a new curb cut to the highway, which would be next to impossible to do. So you're talking about moving that northerly ramp slightly to the west, you create a little more room to put in an access road, which would be effectively notched into the hillside going up parallel to the topography to access that property. The benefits of this, we feel, is, first of all, the property is not really marketable from perspective of access on Great Road 146A, the school street exit. It's difficult to get to, there's already traffic circulation issues there. The one benefit of putting a new entry point like this would actually lay the burden there and hopefully attract tenants, which would create a small market to effectively implement the rest of the plan. So we hope that, you know, we're a ways away here. We're only hitting with the first cost proposal, which would effectively allow the town to move an idea forward with DOT. I mean, that's where we need to start. And then we can begin to understand costs. And as to how far we take it, you know, the conceptual thinking right now is if everything went perfectly, we could somehow fund and obtain a PAP from DOT. And if you had that design for the PAP, which would show this ramp being reconfigured, that's 8 months of work, at least that's out of the way. You don't have to worry about doing it when a company comes looking for that space. So it helps us kind of market the space. Hopefully we can get a tenant to actually help maybe even design and fund the cost of making improvement along with the road infrastructure. So that's really all I have to say about that. I know this is Windspace way of looking at the map. One of the consultants did provide a map of the idea that you have.
Mr. Kravitz, I looked at this and I'm going to have my memory refreshed. I spoke with Gary earlier, it's later this afternoon. And I don't recall the council voted to go out to seek an engineering study.
Right.
We may not have to do that under a certain amount of limit, but do we recall what the amount is for engineering study?
Well, engineering service would be professional services, so they would be excluded. So
excluded, okay. Ms. Krabs, so I'm looking at this. Because there was really no RFP, I'm looking at different amount of hours. One is 128 hours of dedicated service to this project. One is 195 hours. One's 135 hours. And if I copy these correctly from looking at it, we have different price costs associated: $17,813, $29,962, $16,675. I want to make this statement really clear to everybody. I'm all for doing this. I just want to make sure we follow the right process, because one of these applicants also gave us was going to give us rough cost estimates and whatnot for this. So I just want to make sure that we're okay to vote on this and to move forward with it and to get the right amount of service at a cost. We're going to do a cost benefits analysis. So I'm for it. I'm just a little not sure how we should approach it. So if anybody could help me with that, Gavin.
Yes. In a circumstance like this, we're actually, it's under the public works section of our ordinance that we pursue three quotes. And you're right, it is a difficult request to make because we don't have a finite scope of work. We're advancing the concept and trying to get the essentially, I guess the best way to describe it is to get something on paper that we can show to state officials to get an indication as to whether or not an entity that really did want to locate there could get access to that location. And I'm prepared to recommend to you that from my review of the three proposals that the CDR McGuire proposal is the one that is I think is in the best interest of the community based on the submission they've made and who they are as it relates to the kind of project that we're looking at.
is someone that has been part of the DOT. The project manager is someone, happens to be a resident, that's not the basis for this, but simply has great experience in these kinds of projects. And the price and hour circumstance, I think, merit the selection. What we're looking at here is beginning the process to make access to from what the Branch River redevelopment study indicated, they quantified 700,000 square feet of new buildings in that park. I think that number could be as high as a million. And what we're looking at for the interests of the town certainly are this tax base and work opportunity for our citizens and for people in the region. We're looking at something that could approach $100 million in new tax base. That's in excess of 5% of our current base. It's about the biggest jump that we could possibly make. It is clearly the biggest jump that we can make in this kind of a development opportunity. So this isn't our land. It is private property. That's an important thing, I think, for everyone to recognize. We're actually trying to encourage development of private property. And this is a small step. Hopefully what this step can give us is the confirmation that the idea has merit and can be approved, providing a substantial more amount of engineering has to be done as part of the development. But give the idea that to get it toward the pad-ready concept that anyone who is trying to develop this kind of property needs to get to, a la Quonset Point is the kind of thing to look at. So it's a lot of money, relatively speaking, for the town. With the proposal that's been made at just over $17,000, $17,853, is my recommendation that we go forward.
All right. One legal clarification, David. We vote to approve tonight on the 17-5. Right? Help me out with this talk. We authorize the administrative after we vote to go the next step and start the ball rolling to go to DOT. That being to go to the engineers.
My understanding.
The engineers actually would be going to DOT.
Would be going to DOT.
That would stop the process.
That's the process. They're looking to get a PAP permit, right?
Right.
So I'm going to make a motion. It'd be basically a motion to accept the town administrator's recommendation to retain the service of the CDR pursuant to the proposal that they presented. Because there's three proposals for three different engineers.
I understand that. He's recommending that. So I'll make that motion. That's my motion.
Okay. Can I second the discussion?
Sure.
Funding coming out of Public Works? Where's this funding coming from?
Council continues.
Do we know where we are at council?
The infrastructure contingency has $105,000 per year.
Okay, beautiful. Thank you.
Good question.
Thank you.
On this map that I have, is that like a realistic piece? And who would it eventually take that? The state?
The state owns the land. In order for this to happen, an entity would have to buy that land from the state. Go through the process at DOT for that to be able to gain the access needed.
So this is considered a driveway?
No, it will become a roadway. It will become a town road.
All right. The long green one into the back of that will become a town road.
Town road that actually, the way the Branch River development, redevelopment plan was established, it would be essentially a network of roads inside that development that leading out to the two access points on the Old Great Road.
And we wouldn't have anything to do with any of those roads.
So it would be private development.
Seems like an old brain.
Okay.
Mr.
President,
it's going to be the
17853, thank you.
What was the number?
17853.
Which will be the infrastructure contingency somewhere around 87. $27K left in the paper, right? Thank you.
If we have a motion, we do it in a second, you're right. Any further discussion? Okay, roll call, please.
Mr. Malvin?
Yes.
Mr. McKee?
Yes.
Mrs. O'Hara?
Yes.
Mr. Zalinski?
Yes.
Mr. Bureau?
Yes, thank you. Ms. Pendergast, you're up.
I know, I'm getting too old to get to know that.
Discussion by council, vote on other action on award of bid for fencing at the Department of Public Works and Bushy School Playground. Pendergast.
Good evening. Throw my glasses, so I'll go over this second again. Want to follow mine? That's all right, I'm in, let's see how it goes. Back on April 26th, was a public reading regarding the playground fencing, fencing at the DPW slash recycling area, which is behind the public works facility. There were three bids. After reviewing these bids, it was broken into two projects, Project 1 and Project 2. Project 1 being DPW's recycling area, and the second one being the fencing at the Bushy Memorial Park Annex Playground that we have a grant to use on that playground, which I'll explain in a minute. The three bids were opened, and as a result, North Smithfield Fence on St. Paul Street was the low qualified responsive bidder, Project 1 and for Project 2. Project 1 being $14,075, Project 2 being the Bushy Memorial Playground, $8,800. I recommend the North Smithfield Fence for both Project 1 and Project 2.
Okay, then the other questions, Ms. Pendergast?
Make the motion to approve.
Your second?
Second.
Further discussion? Roll call, please.
Mr. Malvin?
Yes.
Mr. McKee?
Yes.
Mrs. O'Hara?
Yes.
Mr. Zalinski?
Yes.
Mr. Bureau?
Yes. And we have one more for you, sir. Discussion by council, vote on other action on award of bid for paving in the Department of Public Works at the Chico Park Basketball Court. Pendergast?
On the same date, April 26th, we entertained two separate projects for paving at the DPW recycling area behind the public works facility and for the paving of the basketball courts at the Chico Park. As a result of the bid openings, there were five qualified bidders, and the results, I believe you have the attached sheet, were that for Project 1, which was the DPW recycling area, the lowest qualified responsive bidder was D'Amber Construction from Warwick, Rhode Island, at $51,775. And for Project 2, Narragansett Improvement was the low bidder for the basketball courts at Pacheco Park for $29,712. Since the opening of those bids and my reviewing of that last Thursday, I had a conversation with the finance director, and the bid for the basketball courts, Project 2, came in slightly higher than I anticipated. As a result, the memo I just gave you, which I apologize that it didn't be a package by the deadline, we kind of summarized it up today. There's not enough funds to complete that project. So I'm respectfully requesting that Project 2, basketball court at Pacheco Park, be pulled from any award tonight, and I have to regroup myself and figure something out. Not that the project won't happen, that I have to change the RFP and change some different things. So the only thing that I'm requesting tonight is the awarding of the DPW recycling area.
So just for the record, though, what we were talking about earlier, did not, the fact that D'Amber did not bid on the basketball court, that gives them an advantage over, over the other companies?
I have to be honest with you, the Amber, the mandatory, we had a mandatory pre-bid meeting. They were right up front with me and said that we do not do basketball tennis courts, we do roads and parking lots. So we're not going to bid on the basketball court. I said, you don't have to. The reason in my RFP that I broke this down into project one, project two, is that I get a true number for each project. Instead of then lumping it all together, I have no idea what it would cost me for basketball courts. So as a result, when I analyzed these Thursday, I knew that I only had about $34,000 left in capital funds from 2015, 2016. I still haven't bought the basketball hoops. There's still some fencing that has to be done. So I have to kind of change the scope of the RFP so that we don't exceed the funds that we have. That is specified right in the RFP that we, the finance director has the authority to not award this because there's not enough funds.
So it wasn't necessary to go and get two RFPs in the beginning?
I just did one RFP with project one and two on the fencing.
Okay.
I've done it on road material. I've done it on trash and recycling.
This is just a response to somebody.
Yep.
That I got.
I tried to explain that situation to that gentleman. And
okay.
So in fairness, I think to everyone, I'm pulling. And people will have the chance to rebid it if they want to.
All right.
Can I ask a question? Finance director, how much are you short for payment at Chico?
Sorry?
How much funding? Funding. How much are you short? If we just awarded 17, 18, we're down to 87K. How much funding is needed to get these both these projects finished, right? Would that help you or do you want to put it off?
I think I can help on that. What happened was you gave us the authority, the last council, there was a $75,000 grant to the four tennis courts at the high school to crack seal and resurface and paint those courts. That expenditure was paid, and we had a balance of $37,000, roughly $37,000. I came before the council and requested that we do this basketball court and renovations of Pacheco Park with the remaining $37,000. We've done some miscellaneous work at Pacheco Park, and I believe right now that the balance was in the area of
$34,000.
$32,741. $32,000, that's even worse than I thought. So now, I was anticipating this bid, some of the quotes that I had sought got me in the area of around $20,000. My personnel are actually going to do the excavating and clearing of this court. So all I was paying for was the resurfacing and the paint. And I kind of think these bids are kind of high, and that's why I broke it into the two projects. But as a result, after analyzing this, we have $32,000, and I go with a little bid of 29 and change, let's call it 30 for the sake of argument, two basketball hoops are coming in around $5,000. So, as other projects have happened in the past, I am not going to exceed, and I just figure I can regroup myself and do a new RFP.
When is this project supposed to be done?
The unfortunate part of this project, and I'm going to probably get this RFP turned around before so that we can have this work before you for the first meeting in June. This is part of an Eagle Scout project for a young boy in town. And he's kind of against the gun by the middle of the summer to get this completed. I know that he's pushing for the end of May, but I think that we can get this done. And I'll turn to you for your expertise on this, Mr. President. When we did the tennis courts, the company that did it for our seal coating told me when we did the courts that we could not do these unless the temperature stayed above 50 degrees for a certain amount of time.
Yeah, but these are special coating for this tennis courts and basketball courts. I don't deal with that stuff, but I painted on top of it, and I know that it has sit for several days before we paint.
So when I remembered that from that company last fall, I said to myself, I can at least buy myself a little time to get to the beginning of June. My personnel will have this done in a couple of days, and if it's awarded at the beginning of June, I think the turnaround will be mid-June. I think it will work out fine for everybody. If I get that up
and down. The courts and everything?
New court.
Oh, okay. And if you had the money today, when would it be done?
Probably within 2 weeks, 2 or 3 weeks. I have a couple other projects that kind of
come. And what is it, $5,000?
How much are you short?
Well, we're short. If you go with the 30 plus 5, that's 35, you're short $3,000.
$3,000?
That's where I was going with finance. How much are you short?
Right.
grand?
$3,000.
$3,000.
So, Keith, why don't we take that contingency?
The sum is short, and kids want to have fun, I say.
Yes.
If Ray's comfortable, are you comfortable?
I would like to change some, a couple of things in our page.
Okay.
Can you go back to the May 15th meeting?
I can come back, I mean, if I want to change the RFP though, I don't know if I can be able to get it turned around that quick.
But you'll know in 10 days or so before, so you'll get to the point where I can do it. If it's done, you'll come up on the 15th.
If I can get it done that fast, I will. If not, it'll definitely be by the meeting, the first meeting, definitely.
Make a motion that the issue be withdrawn.
Second.
Continue to May 15th, 10 to May.
I'll shoot for it. It's probably going to be the same vendor as that bid on it, so they've already got it. It's just kind of changing a couple of the paint, the type of paint, stuff like that. The funding, I think it is a funding, I know the finance director's going to get the funding on this.
Dan, you sure, because we can do this tonight, are you sure you want to hold on?
Okay.
Okay, we're going to follow the recommendation.
I just made a motion to continue.
Well, until 15.
To the 15th.
We got a second?
Second.
I see.
Okay, roll call.
Mr. Halloran?
Yes.
Mr. McGee?
Yes.
Mrs. O'Hara?
Yes.
Mr. Zalinski?
Yes.
Mr. Biragad?
Yes.
So did.
We have to still make a. Yeah, we're still going to accept the Amber, right? Okay. We have a motion to accept the Amber construction proposal for the parking lot in public works for $51,775.
So moved.
Second. Any further discussion? Roll call.
Halloran?
Yes.
Mr. McGee?
Yes.
Mrs. O'Hara?
Yes.
Mr. Zalinski?
Yes.
Mr. Biragad?
Yes. I think that's it, right?
Thank you.
Thanks.
Can I ask you something? Do we actually have at Butch's School, a playground? Is this a playground the other day? It used to be a bunch of plastic, broken plastic stuff.
Yeah, it is, well, it is. And unfortunately, most of the playgrounds in town all have that equipment that was put in about 20 years ago, and it's time to go. So we're kind of chipping away each of the playgrounds. This playground, Bushy, that we were awarded this contract with TDM, but it's in terrible shape, but it's going to be very nice part. The resident, Mr. Malucci, is a driving force behind this. We had some great conversations. It kind of took a while, but we were awarded the grant. It's going to be a tight park for little children to learn how to ride their bicycles, yeah. Tricycles, figure eight, very nice. It's going to be very nice. So.
That's great. Thank you.
Mr. Malucci is going to be happy.
Moving on to the last item on the agenda. Discussion by council vote of other action on resolution regarding early voting. Mr. Halloran is responsible for this. Yes,
a resolution in opposition to 2017-H-5511, 2017-S-0169, and 2017 resolution S-0422. Whereas the rights of citizens of the town of North Smithfield to cast votes in all elections is a matter of paramount to the importance of North Smithfield Town Council, and whereas the existing process of providing mail ballots for anyone who cannot attend an election at the polls on election day ensures that each citizen has the opportunity to cast a vote in the privacy and comfort of their home. Whereas 2017-H-5700, 2017-H-5511, 2017-S-0169, and 2017-S-0422 will require the town of North Smithfield to provide early voting 20 days prior to the election and will include Monday through Friday, regular business hours, and one weekend prior to the election in 2018, and two weekends prior to the election in 2020. Whereas the town of North Smithfield does not have a canvassing block at 2017-H-5700, 2017-H-5515, 2017-S-0619, and 2017-S-0422. 044-0422, or to buy the town of Nelson Field to add staff and hire additional, and or hire additional staff, present during the regular working hours, and result in temporary costs and expenses allowed significant impact on town's budget. Now therefore be resolved, Nelson Field Town Council hereby opposes passage of this 2017 H-5700, 2017 H-5511, 2017 S-06619, and 2017 S-0422, and request another resolution to General Assembly and the governor oppose the passage of these bills. Throughout this, the town clerk is hereby directed to forward a copy of this resolution to members of the Rhode Island House of Representatives and the Rhode Island State Senate and the governors of Rhode Island. Shall not take effect upon passage. Sponsored by me, but the work was done by the administrator and the solicitor. I just have to raise a question to you, gentlemen, that we don't have a board of elections. We're like typical, like small communities. We don't have all those things. We're going to be having people sitting in that clerk's office, one person on weekends, working 7 days a week. I think that's wrong. And I don't know where we can get the additional staff, and getting additional staff is not that easy because they have to be trained. So if we had a big election department like, say, Providence or Cranston or something, it might very well be feasible. But I know I have spoken to clerks in the past, and when they had those special elections or days to register on a Saturday, they have one person, no one can come in. So I'm asking you, gentlemen, I think it should be done for the reasons to say it's going to hurt us financially, but also I think it should only apply to the biggest cities, or if it's going to happen, I think that someone from the governor's Secretary of State's office should be the ones supplying the people to come into the town. No, I'm just stating, so I better make a motion.
Yeah.
You're on a lot of trouble.
You're one of my idols. One of my idols.
Am I saying what else I speak on this? I make the motion to be.
A second for a comment.
Go ahead.
I just want to compliment you, Council Allenberg, for taking the initiative to put this through. I think it's going to, it's the right thing. Thank you, Mr. Allenberg.
Yeah, I agree. I think voting, you should have to make an effort to vote. It shouldn't be as
But if we need someone to work 24 hours on a Saturday, I'm sure Mrs. Todd
will work.
Thank you, Mrs. Todd.
No, she's going to work the toll
booth. Okay, we have a second on that, and any further discussion? Roll call.
Yes.
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 Microphone's off?
Yes. Is there a motion to adjourn?
Yes.
All in favor?